Students, here we go for your solution. First, we will start with section A. Our first question is, a proton and an electron travel in a magnetic field. Now, you have to tell which one moves in a circular path with higher frequency. The answer is electron, because the frequency is equal to qb divided by 2 pi m and the frequency is inversely proportional to mass. The mass of electron is less as compared to proton. So if mass is less, then frequency is higher. So answer is electron. Okay, next question is question number 2. Name the electromagnetic radiations for water purifications and second for eye surgery. The first one is water purification. We will use the UV ray, and for eye surgery, we will use X-rays. This is the answer. Now our next third question is, we have to plot a graph showing the variation of the photoelectric current with voltage having equal frequency but different intensity. So this is your graph. The graph is between anode potential and the current. Here the two different intensities, I1 and I2. I2 is greater than I1. So this is your graph which you have to plot in this question. Our next question, you have to tell here, four nuclei fused together form a heavy nucleus. Tell me which of the two parent or daughter nuclei would have higher binding energy per nucleon. The answer is daughter nuclei. The reason, when the fusion takes place, the mass number increase and the binding energy is increased with mass number. That's why the answer is daughter nuclei. Our next question, question number 5th. You have to tell which mode of propagation is used by short wave broadcast services. The answer is sky wave propagation, right? Okay, here is the section B. We will try to solve only numerical part here. Your question number 6. You have the two bulbs P and Q having resistance ratio is 1:2. And you have to find out the power dissipation in these bulbs when these bulbs are connected in series. This is your answer. This is given part, resistance of P and resistance of Q 1:2. And the power is equal to I square R in case of series. You can see here the power is directly proportional to resistance. That's why resistance of P by Q is equal to power of P by Q equals to 1/2. This is your answer. The next question is question number 7. In question number 7, we have given two batteries, 200 volt, 10 volt with a resistance 38 ohm, and you have to find out the value of the current in this circuit. Simply apply Kirchhoff's law, Kirchhoff's voltage law. Summation of voltage is equal to the product of current and resistance. 200 minus 10 is equal to current into resistance. Solve it and find the value of the current. Here is your answer, 5 ampere. Okay friends, next question, question number 9. This is numerical part again. Question number 9. The light of wavelength 412.5 nanometer is given, which is incident on a metal plate. Here different metals are given with different work functions. Find out which one shows the photoelectric emission. Simply, wavelength is given here. First of all, by this wavelength, make it energy. Energy is equal to hc by lambda. The value of hc is 1240 and the wavelength is 412.5. Solve this, you will get 3 electron volt. Therefore, incident energy must be, this is incident energy. Incident energy must be greater than the work function for photoelectric emission. You can see here the sodium and potassium. The sodium and potassium having work function is less than incident energy. That's why your answer is sodium and potassium. Here is question number 10, which is again a numerical. Here, a carrier wave of peak voltage 15 volt is used to transmit a massive signal. Find the peak voltage of modulating signal. Modulation index is 60%. Simply a relation here, mu equal to AM by AC. The given part is amplitude of carrier wave and the modulation index 60%. You have to find out the value of AM. Simply put these given values in this relation. We will get the peak voltage of modulating signal equals to 9 volt. This is your answer. Okay, here is your next question, question number 13. A bar magnet having magnetic moment 6 joule per tesla, and initially it is an angle of 60 degree with uniform magnetic field, and the value of magnetic field is 0.44 tesla.
You have to find out the work done in turning the magnet to align its magnetic moment normal to the magnetic field, and the second opposite to the magnetic field. Opposite to the magnetic field means angle 180, and normal to the magnetic field means angle 90 degree. So here is the solution. The work done is equal to minus MB cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. Theta 1 is the initial angle and theta 2 is the final angle. According to the question, theta 2 is 90 degree. That is normal, and initially it was at 60 degree. Put the values, value of M, value of B, theta 2, theta 1. Calculate. The finally answer is this. The work is equal to 1.32 joule. Our next part is theta 2 is 180 degree. That is opposite to the magnetic field. Again, you have to put the values. You will get the answer. Work done is equal to 3.96 joule. Its second part, torque. The torque is equal to MB sin theta, MB from above given values, and the theta is 180 degree because you have to use the second case, theta 2 180 degree. Finally, sin 180 is 0, that's why torque is 0. Okay students, these are the answers of question number 13. Here is question number 17. A symmetric biconvex lens of radius of curvature R made of glass having refractive index 1.5 is placed on a liquid layer. Here is your liquid. Liquid layer placed on the top of the plain glass mirror. An optical needle with its tip on the principal axis of the lens is moved along the axis until the real and inverted image coincides with needle itself. The distance of the needle from the lens is measured to be x. This distance is x. On removing the liquid, when you remove the liquid, on removing the liquid and repeating the experiment, the distance is found to be y. Obtain the expression for the refractive index of the liquid in terms of x and y. Here, I want to share one thing. This is the question, last question of NCERT of ray optics. The similar questions is there. Okay, here is your solution. First of all, the upper part of this lens is convex lens, and this is the lens maker formula. 1 by half is equal to mu minus 1 lens, refractive index of lens, radius of curvature of first surface and second surface. Put the given values, you will get the value of F1 is equal to R. On the other face where there is liquid, it will behave as a concave lens. Again, you have to use the lens maker formula, 1 by half 2 mu minus 1 1 over R, and the second surface is plane mirror, that's why R2 is equal to infinity. 1 by infinity is 0. Solve it, you will get the value of F2, R divided by mu minus 1. Now calculate the equivalent focal length, 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. Here from first and second, the value of F1 and F2 put here, and we get the required equivalent focal length, 2 minus mu divided by R. Since without liquid, the image is formed at the y distance, you have to write this line in the last, in the end of this question. Okay students, here is the question number 18, and we will solve only the numerical part. You know, and the question number 18 B part is a numerical. A hydrogen atom initially in the ground state absorb a photon which excite it to the n equal to 4 level. Estimate the frequency of the photon. Very simple question guys. Here is the solution. 18 B part. You know the relation between the wavelength, Rydberg constant, and the value of the n, final minus initial orbit number, the value of the r, 10 key power 7. Finally, it is at fourth level, that's why nf is equal to 4, and initially it was at ground state. Ground state means n equals to 1. Put the values, you will get the value of 1 by lambda. You know very well, frequency is equal to c by lambda, c 3 into 10 key power 8 and 1 by lambda. From here, put here, solve it, you will get the answer of frequency in terms of hertz. Next question. Okay students, your next question is question number 19, and numerical part is here B. A radioactive isotope has a half-life of 10 years. How long will it take for the activity to reduce to 3.125%? Very simple question again, simply formula based here. The given values is half-life 10 years and number of atoms at an instant is equal to 3.125% of original value. This comes here n by n naught, 3.125% due to percent, we will divide it 100, n by n naught. Solve it, you will get 1 by 132. 1 by 132 is equal to 1 by 2 key power 5. This is the value of n, and you know the relation, n by n naught is equal to 1 by 2 key power n. and the value of n is equal to t by t. The value, compare these two equations, the value of n is 5 and the value of n in terms of t, t by t, this is 5. Cross multiply, the value of capital T means half life is 10. Solve here, you will get the 50 years. This is your final answer, guys. Here is your next question, question number 25. B part, this is again a numerical here. Very simple numerical from the chapter EMI, electromagnetic induction. An aeroplane is flying horizontally from west to east with a velocity of 900 km per hour. This is the velocity of aeroplane. Calculate the potential difference developed between the ends of the wing, which having a span 20 meter. This is the length of the wings. Value of L. The horizontal component of the earth magnetic field is 5 into 10 to the power minus 4 Tesla, and the value of angle of dip is 30 degree. Simply, first of all, write the given values. Velocity 900 km per hour, convert it in meter per second, multiply it with 5 by 18, you will get 250 meter per second. The value of horizontal magnetic field is this, the value of angle of dip is 30 degree. As we know, the 10 delta is equal to the vertical component divided by horizontal component. Simply cross multiply it. Simply cross multiply it, you will get BV is equal to the BH into 10 delta. Put the value of BH from above, 5 into 10 to the power 4, and the value of delta is 30 degree. Simply solve the value of B vertical. You know very well the value of the induced EMF you have to find here, and E is equal to BLV. Please notice one thing here, the value of B, L and V should be perpendicular to each other. That's why the aeroplane is flying horizontally. You have to take the vertical component of the magnetic field. That's why we calculate BV. Put the value of BV here. The length 20 and the velocity 250 from here. Calculate it. You will get the net potential difference. So here is the solution of your 12th class physics paper. If you have any doubt, you can comment. And if you like, please don't forget to share and subscribe our channel. Thank you, students.